Scratch that itch and slap that bitch. Welcome to the Kevin Colley Show.
Show. I'm your host, Kevin Holly, and not feeling very well. I'm just kidding. I feel great. I feel real good. Feels so good. I am pleasantly surprised, happy, and excited to announce my co-host for tonight, sitting in for Jaybird, Pops, Philbert, and Homeless Chuck, the one and only. Hey, Aaron. What's up, Aaron?
What's going on, man? How you doing?
I'm good, brother. Thank you for coming, bro.
No worries, man. I come whenever you ask.
And it's already time for cock chat. Oh, wow, man. So much to get into tonight. There's so much to get into. I don't even know where to begin. But I know I could probably just kill this God forbid intro. Good Lord. It's getting old as hell, dude.
Yeah, it kind of is, man. I'll tell you, man, that bass, when it's in my car, when I'm listening while I'm working, it's pretty intense.
Yeah, yeah. I like to drop the bass, man. Do you remember DJ Bass Boy?
No. Probably back in the 30s and 40s if you were around.
Do you remember DJ Magic Mike? What?
Do you mean Channing Tatum?
the real Magic Mike.
No, I don't know.
He's like... It was just like a bass tape. You remember having? You never had bass tapes when you were a lad.
No, a young not one? At all.
You're still young. You're 30.
Yeah, I'm 29. Asshole.
Jesus Christ! You should still have a bass tape then. Goddamn it!
I'm gonna
burn you a bass CD.
There you go.
Speaking of CDs,
nuts.
It's time to start the show, dude. Come on. So, all right, we're not on the IRN right now. The Internet Radio Network, irnbroadcast.com, because some other show hijacked the stream tonight, and I don't know if I should blame it on Glick. It's not the Glick show. It's Open Mic Live.
It's probably Rob Haas's fault. That guy's an asshole.
I just drooled. Oh, my God, dude. Sorry. Do you have any hand sanitizer?
No.
That's all.
I thought you were going to ask me for a handy.
Cool. What's up?
All right, guys. I'll be right back.
Yeah, we're going to take a break real quick here. Take our first 3-8-minute
30-second break. It's Kevin.
Well, you know. Anyway. So a lot happened today, Aaron. A lot happened today. They caught the Seminole Heights killer.
Well, see, and that's the thing is he has not admitted to it. There's been no confession. I honestly think they're just trying to close the case to get it off everyone's back so some of the heads can relax. And then if something may happen again, God forbid it does, but if it does, then they're going to have to reopen the case all over again. You know, so why don't you get a guy and actually prove that it was him?
I don't think the case is closed, you know.
They said they're... If they got the guy, then the case is technically closed. I mean, they're still investigating stuff that's going on.
They still have to prosecute him.
True story.
Yeah, so it's not closed. What about the McDonald's where they found him, the McDonald's?
It was right on Ybor, man. Right off of Palm, I think it's like Palm Avenue or 50th Street or whatever the hell that is. But yeah, it's the only McDonald's in Ybor.
The only McDonald's in Ybor.
Yeah, so you should know where it is.
We both said it wrong. It's McDonald's.
Oh, McDonald's.
Yeah. Are they going to close that? Is that case closed?
Mac-a-D's. No, it's crazy. So he had his gun, and he handed it to his manager and said, hold this. I'm going to go to Amscot and get a payday loan. No. And then they put it in a McDonald's bag, and they handed it over to an officer that was in the McDonald's.
Yeah.
And then he took it, and they explained to him what it was, and then called for backup. And when the guy showed back up with his payday loan, he got arrested.
Now, allegedly, he actually got a payday loan, you know.
Correct.
Okay, we don't know for sure if that happened. And from what I heard, and now I haven't really investigated it, except I listened to talk radio all day today, right? Driving around, you know, I put in 8 hours in my car today. And from what I gathered, Dan Maderi from 820 Florida Live, whatever it is. Yeah, Florida Live, right? Or is that Eric Casilius? I don't know. One of those. It was Dan Maderi. I don't know the name of the show. But anyway, I think he had it wrong. He was saying that what you said, that the killer handed over his gun and said, hold this. And then took off and walked. Instead of taking his car, he walked over to cash a check at Amscot or get a payday loan.
Yeah.
Well, on another show, the Drew Garabo show, I heard that he actually had it in his regular backpack or whatever, his satchel, if you will. And that he put it in, like, the employee, like, area where you put your stuff. And one of the employees, like, because I guess these employees, the girl that turned him in, they would make fun of the guy, say, you look just like the Seminole Heights killer, you know? And he didn't think it was funny. Yeah, he didn't think it was funny. And so when he put his bag down and then said, I'll be right back, I think is when the girl went and looked in his bag. I also heard accounts that he was trying to sell a gun at work.
Yeah, and supposedly he bought it in November, but the shooting started in October. But now they're proving that he bought it in October. And the same rounds and everything are, they're all Smith & Wesson. I can't remember the caliber and whatnot, but they're saying that the bullets match up, but they haven't ran ballistics to see if it's the actual bullets that are matching up.
Yeah, well, yeah, the shell casings and whatnot. Yeah. I think that, I mean, I listened to a bunch of different talk radio shows today, and I watched a little bit of news. I watched the 11 o'clock presser last night. I didn't watch the presser this morning, but I listened to portions of it on the radio today. And from what I understand from the different shows that I listened to, is that he, you know, basically just, you know, put his bag down or whatever. And I think that, I don't know, dude, I think they got him. I think it's him, man. They had bloody clothing.
I heard that as well.
But why didn't he leave the gun in his car? You know what I mean?
Why didn't he just take his bag with him?
Right.
I mean, why would you leave, if it was the murder weapon, why would you leave the murder weapon out for other people to find?
Right, maybe he didn't think anybody would go through his bag, maybe?
I don't know.
But then
you got another thing is there was a $110,000 reward out for someone who gave information. Now they're trying to find a loophole to not pay the girl that gave the officer the gun. But the owner of the Columbia came in to McDonald's today, as a matter of fact, and he wrote, because he said he's going to offer $9,000. Hmm. So he wrote a $9,000 check to the girl today in the McDonald's.
I got a report here in the chat room from Glick that the mics are distorted and sound bad. I turned them down. Does that sound better? Or is Glick just messing with us, man?
Glick, don't be a dick.
Oh, man, I wonder. Is that better? Is that better, Glick? Ah, Jesus. It should be fine now.
I can't get in the chat room.
And the levels look
good. I can't get in the chat room, man.
Why not?
I don't know. I'm a little confused on this.
You're a little
confused? I'm on Spreaker. I'm running the show live. I just don't see where the chat room is.
It's that little, like, cloud. Looks like a... I don't know what the hell's going on with the studio, man. Hoppy ruined it. Hoppy ruined my studio. I don't know, Aaron.
Yeah, I guess we'll have to figure it out on our first hour break.
Yeah, I guess so. Let me see if I can turn these down a little bit. Maybe that's a little bit better. I think that should be a little bit better.
Because Glick's in the Spreaker chat room, right?
Yeah, he's in there. I'm in there. Why aren't you in there?
Beats me. I never even got an email saying that we were going live on Spreaker. Like I normally do.
Yeah, that's because I can't post anything on Facebook because I'm in Facebook jail right now.
No, but Spreaker normally sends me an email.
Oh, really?
Saying, oh, you're going live.
Well, that's on you, dude.
Let me try that.
Yeah, you should try something.
I am.
He says they're all screwy. God bless it, dude. What the hell? What is up with this place, dude? It's like a dungeon in here, man. Maybe if I just smack the board a little bit. How's that? Is that better?
It did something.
I mean, I just turned down the volumes a lot. I mean, dude, I did 5 tests last night because of that echo on Happy Hour.
Oh, yeah. That was pretty funny.
Yeah, it totally was. But it sounded great. Now, all of a sudden, I'm getting feedback from Glick about feedback on our show. I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm not happy about this. Glick, I think you should call the show. Anybody that wants to call the show, 727-237-6010.
Nope. We got a message.
Message?
We got a message. It's Lori. Don't need to come home.
Oh, it was Stan. But he says, I love you, bro. Oh, that's great. Lori's really mad at me. Well, she's not really mad at me. She was for a few minutes, so. Do you want to know why?
Sure, yeah, go ahead.
I mean, I don't want to talk about it until I know the mics are working fine, though, you know?
That's true.
You know what I mean?
Glick, how do they sound?
Come on, Glick, a little feedback, man. Hook us up, man.
Feedback, huh? Get it? Boom.
It's like I'm in a tunnel or something. Man. I'm really getting tired of this, man. I mean, is it the board? You know what I mean? I don't know. You gonna go outside and check it? Oh, you're the man. I'll continue to talk about nothing while that's happening. So last night was a lot of fun. I sat in on Hoppy Hour with Steve Moonshine Miller, the very popular stand-up comic out of Tampa Bay here. And it was absolutely hilarious, totally funny. The last, 5 minutes of the show was when Hoppy broke my mixer. And we had all this echo, and oh, it was terrible. How does this sound?
Hello, motherfucker.
Does that sound better? What about a little bit of this?
Hi, Kevin.
I don't know, man. I don't know what to say. I mean, everything on my end looks perfect. I mean, there's dead silence when I'm not talking. No noise in the background. Oh, Glick says, you know whose show never has issues with mics or cameras? Is that the dick show?
Glick, you never know if there are issues because you're drunk.
Who isn't? Plenty of drunk people around here. That's not the feedback I was looking for, though. Hey, Aaron, what did it sound like out there?
I can't even pull it up.
Oh, my God. You can't even pull it up.
Not on the app or anything.
He says, I'll give you a hint. The fucking Glick show. The fucking Glick show? Really? All right, I'm going to pull it up right now in real time and play it through my microphone and see how the feed sounds on my own here.
Is it going to feed back?
I hope not. We'll see.
Can we listen to it on here?
Well, it will come out of there, yeah, but, dude, I think I renamed the show 115 on accident. We already did that show. Whatever. So it should be 116. All right, here it is. Here's our show live right now.
Hey, guys, how you doing? I'm going to do a little bit of a mic test here.
Okay, well, it does sound a little tinny, but it's not that bad. I can live with that. It's okay. It is what it is, but it's not horrible. Yeah, not as horrible as the Glick show. I mean, that show fucking blows, man. I mean, when I listen to it, I get a headache. And then, I try to drown myself in my pool, nude. Speaking of being nude, do you want to know why Lori's mad at me?
Yeah, man, what's going on?
All right, Lori got mad at me today. I don't know, about a week ago, I was on Facebook, and I think it was Facebook, and I can't remember exactly where. I managed to get an email address from somebody else's post, and they were talking about that show Naked and Afraid. You know that show?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, God, where is this going?
Yep. Well, the show Naked and Afraid, for those of you listening that don't know what that show's about, basically they take a man and a woman, and the show brings them to a remote location. It could be the Andes Mountains. It could be a remote island in the Caribbean or, you know, the Philippines. It could be anywhere in the world where it's tough to survive. It's even tougher to survive if you're naked, right? And you have nothing. And they drop these people off. And Glick in the chat room says she's mad because I'm not a full-sized man. Anyway. Excuse me. So, Lori's watched the show with me before, okay? And we enjoy the show. Naked and Afraid is a cool show. These people get dropped off, they disrobe, and they walk into whatever the environment is where the shooting is going to be, and they have to survive for 21 days naked with nothing. They have a satchel with a map, and they get to pick one item, and usually it's like a fire starter or like a hatchet or a survival knife where they can use it to chop wood, build a shelter.
I'd bring a fleshlight.
A fleshlight?
I mean, flashlight.
Flashlight. When the batteries... I mean, you got to survive 21 days, dude. What do you need a flashlight for? You could use it to club a seal, I guess. You know, eat the blubber.
That's true.
You got to cook it, though. I guess you could start a fire with a lens, maybe. I don't know. Look, I'm so good at this already, dude.
There you go.
My point is that...
Do you want to go on vacation?
That's another thing, dude. Another aspect of it. I was fortunate enough to steal an email address from somebody that works for the production company that does Naked and Afraid. And I sent a quick email that said, I'd love to be on Naked and Afraid.
Did you really?
I did, dude. And like, I don't know, a few days later, I got a reply. And it said, do you have time to talk? I'm on Pacific time. What time is good? And I was like, anytime. And I put my phone number out, right? So today, I'm driving around. Ubering, right? That's what I'd do, right? And my phone rings, and it's on the Bluetooth, and I'm like, hello, this is Kevin. And it's the lady that sent the email.
My gosh.
Yeah, and she's like, hey, do you got a few minutes to talk? It's, you know, so-and-so from Naked and Afraid, you know? And I was like, yeah. And I pulled over into a Target parking lot, and I took it off Bluetooth, and I talked to her for like 20, 25 minutes, something like that. And she asked me all these questions, like, you know, why do you think you would be a good fit for the show? I was very honest. I said, you know, I noticed that a lot of the people that are on the show are like ex-military, you know, people that teach like surviving classes, you know, things like that. I'm none of those things, you know, but I think I could do it, you know. And we went back and forth, and she asked me all these like classic interview style questions, like, what makes you mad? Do you have tattoos? Are they offensive? Do you have a passport? What are you doing in March of 2018? You know?
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. And so I had this long, drawn-out...
Do you get awesome paid for movie. It or no?
I don't know yet. And if you don't get paid for it, I'm not going to do it. I'm already pretty much not going to do it. I don't know. I mean, unless Lori has a change of heart, because she was like, hell no! You know?
Oh,
she got mad, dude.
She honestly did get mad.
She got hot.
I mean, I think that'd be a good opportunity, you know?
I think so.
That would put your name out there.
Yeah. She just doesn't want me to be naked with another woman, you know?
Yeah,
It's not like it's a porno shoot, you know?
No, like you're... dirty, you're nasty, you know.
Have you seen the show?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
I mean, you gotta make a grass skirt, right?
Yeah, I mean, you can.
Yeah, I'm gonna have a fig leaf or something to cover up my enormous genitalia.
It'll probably be a pine needle. Not really a fig leaf.
No, several pine needles, you know. But anyway, so I had this awesome interview, and she says, okay, I like you. I'm gonna go ahead and pitch you to my team. And if they like you, then so-and-so is going to call you and at the end of the week and let you know. And if you meet the, you know, if they like you, you have to pass a survival test to get your PSR rating, your personal survival rating, you know, whatever it is.
Yeah.
You know how they put the, like, picture of you before and after and you start off with a PSR of, like, 6.0 out of 10 or whatever. I'm sure my PSR rating will be, like, a 2.5 or something, you know, based on my height. I don't know. But, she's like, it's like a phone interview. They're going to ask you questions like, what would you do in this climate? How would you start a fire? How would you hunt? How would you provide food? She's asking me questions like, do you know how to build a shelter?
Because they want you to survive. You know, because if you don't survive, then they don't really have a show.
Exactly.
They just have a dead guy.
Yeah, or somebody that tapped out of it. Like,
those ratings will go down.
Yeah, dude. So anyway, I text Lori right after the interview, and I was like, Lori, hypothetically speaking, how would you feel if I was to be on the TV show Naked and Afraid? And her reply, I have it right here. I'll read it to you verbatim. Blah, 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 blah. Here we go. Lori's reply to me was, hell no. She said, why are you asking me this through a text instead of asking me in person? And I already knew it was going to be bad, dude. You know what I mean? I was like, you know, so I came home, and she immediately was like, right there, like, what are you talking about? Did you, like, apply to be on the show? And I was like, well, funny thing, you know, I just happened to come across the email address for somebody that's, you know, interviewing people for the show. I don't even remember. Honestly, Aaron, I don't remember how I got her email address. I want to say it was, like, in one of those Facebook, like, Newport Richie Exchange, you know, like, one of those groups where you buy and sell things, like Craigslist.
Yeah, but, I mean, why would she be in, no offense, a Newport Richie one? If she's some high producer of some sort.
I can't remember how I got it.
That's crazy, though.
She didn't sound high when I talked
to her. Well, I'm kind of hoping that Lori allows you to do it, you know? I mean,
it's not looking good, dude.
It might put you out there a little bit.
Glick says in the chat room, my PSR is dead, and in the first 5 minutes, it would be a Naked and Afraid record.
I believe that, Glick.
Hell no, dude. I would go 21 days, and I'd be like, yeah, can I go another 21? What's up?
Yeah.
You know?
Oh, Glick, by the way, man, I've asked Courtney to leave a couple times. If you could just get her out of my house and get her back up to South Carolina, that'd be great.
That's the best part about the Glick show. Getting rid of Lady Glick after she makes a sandwich. I think Lady Glick should make a show.
Speaking of food.
Yeah, you got a whole bunch of food, dude.
Well, no, not just that. I believe that you did a good deed today, did you not?
I did.
Let's
I did.
Talk about that for a minute, man.
Well, okay. There was homeless people sleeping outside of the front entrance.
And this is like real homeless people, not like homeless Chuck. These are two real homeless people.
Yeah, yeah. And it was weird because like one of them, it looked like they had a teddy bear and one was really short maybe, you know? So I thought it was a kid. And I'm like, oh, man. So I took a quick picture through the door because they were sleeping, you know? And I was going to make a post, like a funny post, like, oh, here we are, dump tower, you know? More vagrants outside. But then I noticed there was like a teddy bear, you know? And my heart sank, and I was like, oh, man, it looks like it might be a mom and a daughter or something like that. So I felt really bad. So I came upstairs into the studio. This was about, like, 6:30, 7 o'clock when I got here. And I gathered all the snacks that we have in the studio, all the candy and bags of chips. I grabbed, like, some Pop-Top canned food, like raviolis that we microwave. I had, like, some Beanie Weenies, you know.
Yeah.
And a couple of bottles of water. There's a couple juice boxes in the fridge. I had an old polo, a clean polo shirt that I wore to the studio one day over my undershirt, and then I took it off because it was so blistering and freaking hot in here. So I was like, you know, I gave that to him. I filled up a bag. It was heavy, bro. It was like easily 8 pounds, yeah. You know, like the size of my junk, you know. You'll see it on Naked and Afraid.
All right.
It'll be blurred, but it'll be a big blur, you know.
All right.
I mean, I can show you now if you want. Anyway, but going back to the chat room again, nope, she's all yours, Aaron. I told you there was no return policy. You must be talking about Lady Glick.
Oh, Jesus.
And he says, I mean, is it really a good if you brag about it on multiple platforms? Well, I need multiple platforms just to reach the microphone, dude. You know? And that sounds all tinny, like I'm not a real boy. I don't know. But yeah, so I opened up the door downstairs a little while before you got here.
Yeah.
And I had this bag of stuff, you know, and before I opened the door, I put my frothy beverage down on the chair because I don't want to be like handing a homeless people food with a beer in my hand, you know. And when I put my beer down on the chair, there was a dollar bill on the floor in the lobby. So I picked it up and shoved it in the bag.
There you go.
Yeah. And I opened up the door and I was like, hey, guys. And they like kind of woke up and looked at me like they were in trouble. And I was like, it's cool. I have something for you. It's food. And the guy was like, thank you, thank you, thank you. And they both sat up, like, Indian style. And I handed them the bag. I put it down. And they immediately went into it. And, dude, you saw it when we went back up.
They were still out there eating.
Yeah, they're, like, having Thanksgiving out there right now with, like, you know, Beanie Weenies and stuff.
So, good, man. That's good.
Yeah, I felt good about it because they didn't seem like the typical streetwalking meth heads that we see around the dump tower.
Yeah.
They seemed like, I got a good look at them. And it seemed like a 40-year-old man and maybe, like, a 70-year-old. Maybe it was his mom.
Damn.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, she looked really weathered, you know. So it was kind of cool to see them chowing down and all that good stuff. So maybe I won't get struck by lightning tonight, you know?
Uh-huh. Hopefully.
Hopefully not.
Yeah, that's what I meant. You know, not that much of a jerk.
Shit. Anyway, so back to Naked and Afraid, man. If anybody out there wants to call Lori B and convince her to let me do it, her phone number is 727. I'm just kidding.
Oh, man, my jaw just dropped. My eyes got really wide.
I know, and I was like, wow, hey, bro.
Someone's here.
Do I have... Who could it be? All right, let's see. I knew that was going to happen. Freaking ads, man. It's ads. Anyway, it's not AIDS. It's cool. It's ads. I know.
Yeah. AIDS is just a gift that keeps on giving.
Oh, dude, you know the first sign of AIDS?
Sex with you?
Sharp pain in the ass. What? I say that all the time. So, last night, I sat in on Hoppy Hour.
Yeah.
And we had Steve Moonshine Miller in the studio.
He was funny, man.
Dude, I was starstruck.
He was ragging on the Hoppy a bunch, man. I was laughing my ass off.
And that's nothing compared to some of the people that have ragged on him before. You know? But he was cool, dude. He was totally cool. Here's a late joke drum.
Oh, there we go. Look at that.
That's for you, dude.
That 30-second ad was over.
Yeah.
Clash of War.
That's pretty much what it was, dude. Did you see that?
Yep.
Yeah, I don't have that. Do you have that?
No.
We should get that and kill each other.
I'm not into that kind of shit.
Cool. Yeah, me either. But, you know, I mean, duty called. If I was on Naked and Afraid and they were like, look, dude, if you want to get off this island, you got to play Clash of whatever.
Titans or War. Yeah. Whatever the heck. Glick, what is it? I'm sure you know.
Glick says they were actually 25, but meth is a hell of a drug. It really ages you.
You would know.
That's the truth, man. I don't know why.
So random.
Yeah. So is the show.
I'm pissed, man, that this shit is not giving me a chat room. We're going to have to figure this out.
Yeah, I think you're just doing something wrong, dude.
Yeah, but like I said, like normally I get an email that says Kevin Holly Show is live right now, and I didn't even get one of those.
Maybe if you go on kevinhollyshow.com, you can pull up the cloud on that, dude. The little cloud thing that shows you where to chat.
Is it the Kevin Holly
Show? No. Did I say the? Yeah. Did I say the?
Yeah, you did.
No, I did not.
Yes, you did.
I said kevinhollyshow.com. No, the.
Some Kevin Holly Shows have a four, some have a the.
Why don't you just calm down, Aaron? Oh, you done it now, Aaron.
You done fucked up.
You done fucked up. Man, I've got heartburn right now. It's pretty bad. I got a headache. I got heartburn. I'm hungry. I have no food left in the studio.
I got a whole fucking pizza and breadsticks and
why aren't you eating that, dude?
Because I'm not going to eat.
Why not?
Because I'm not Jay.
Oh. Where is Jay, man? I miss Jay so much. Oh, my God.
I heard your brother flaked.
Yeah, he flaked out tonight,
man.
That's
pretty shitty.
I am not very knowledgeable.
How come you haven't ever fagged out Glick?
I'm eating a double cheeseburger.
You're eating a double cheeseburger?
I'm eating a double cheeseburger right now.
Whoa, Aaron in the chat room. Welcome, Aaron.
Hey, how you guys doing?
How'd you get there? KevinHollyShow.com?
Yeah.
Hey! Oh! Thank you.
No worries.
Oh, my God, dude. I mean, so many stupid things to do tonight. Anyway, dude. Oh, you're going to hit the magic eight ball here.
Ask it a question.
Okay. You should write down five questions for the pyramid game, too.
Oh, I should.
Yeah,
sure.
I've got my five already. All ready right. to go. Can I ask a question?
Yeah, go to town.
Okay. Is the Glick Show better than the Kevin Holly Show? Shake it good, dude. Shake it good.
It says, concentrate and ask again.
Is the Kevin Holly Show better than the Glick Show?
The reply is hazy. Try again.
Are Holly's Hobbits better than Glickomaniacs? Take your time. We're live.
Yes.
Woo!
The answer is
woo!
Yes.
Hey, man, the board doesn't lie. Board does not lie. Thank you.
Oh, I love when you blow things.
Thank you. I practice a lot, dude. Anyway, so, all right, check it out, man. Let's get right into this, man.
Oh, you said five things for the pyramid game, right?
Yeah, write those down while I load up this awesome news story that I got from my friend Kelly up in New England.
What the fuck is that? that's the naked woman that was hanging out of the car. I remember that. All right.
Did we talk about that?
No, I just remember reading about that.
Okay, cool. We'll talk about that after this. Here we go. We're not going to do news just yet, but this is just something I wanted to bring up like right away because I think it's hilarious. Out of KTVU, Fox 2 in Stockton, what is that, Oklahoma? San Joaquin County. Corey Hughes, a 27-year-old, an inmate serving time on weapons charges, escaped from a work crew Monday afternoon near Interstate 5 in Stockton, right? Deputies are currently searching for the missing inmate. Okay? Check out this guy.
I just want to see that tattoo.
You ready? Look at this dude's face, dude.
What the heck is going on there?
He's got like a skeleton tattoo across his entire mouth.
Entire face.
Yeah. All the teeth, the jaw. And it's all, like, black and gray. It's all just gray, really.
When, what in the right mind? I mean, there's not enough meth that can make some people do that.
The comments is where it's at, dude. The first comment by
Cody
Mark.
Word disguise.
Does he have any distinguishing features that might help the public recognize him? Yeah. Fucking face skeleton tattoo.
Tattoo artist says to him, what do you want?
Yeah.
He says, Halloween faux life.
Faux life. Faux show. This guy says he could be wearing a disguise, so watch out. And it's got a picture of a dude with a paper bag over his head.
Oh, gosh.
It's great, dude. All of you are going to feel pretty silly when he finds a Sharpie and paints a beard and sunglasses on his face. Nobody will ever recognize him.
Oh, God.
Oh, dude. Looks like escaping the work crew wasn't his first bad decision. This person, Claire, says, I'm just here reading through the comments and laughing. Maybe I shouldn't be laughing, but I just can't help it. I mean, how can you not help laughing at that, dude? I mean, any face tattoos, in my humble opinion, are just, like, stupid. I mean, I understand, like, the teardrop and neck tattoos on some people look cool, you know?
I love when, like, some of the guys have, like, these... a set of lips, and you're like, hey, you still with that girl? And he's like, nah, fuck that bitch.
Yeah, yeah, right.
Like, well, you got those lips on there.
Turns out that girl was like 16. Oh,
whoa. Welcome to the Kevin Holly Show.
Oh,
speaking
God,
of penises,
dude.
Did you hear about the Navy pilot who drew the penis in the air?
I did.
And it's not the first time it's being investigated. So you draw a dick in the air, you're going to lose your career just to do something funny?
I mean, I don't think that's that bad, dude. It was definitely funny. I actually have something on that.
Makes me laugh that that's all over Facebook, and that's okay, but if you put a dick on top of Dick Cheney's head, that's not okay.
Thank you. Thank you.
Just so everyone knows, Kevin Holly, the Kevin Holly, Kevin Holly is banned from Facebook for, I think, another 48 hours?
About 20 hours or
20
so.
20 hours left.
Yeah, and change
tomorrow. Watch out, he's coming back.
I'm coming back. Dude, look at, I've got 92 little things on my globe there. 92 notifications.
Dang.
It's going to take me all day.
And you can't watch that?
I can look at it, but I can't like or comment anything.
That is insane.
I know. And it just keeps racking up, dude. That's just on my personal page. That's not counting the show
the page,
page. The fun
all.
Page. Yeah, it's terrible. I had to make a fake persona.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Jimmy Hat.
Because I was a dickhead, dude. You know, Jimmy Hat. Sound good, you know? So here's a little excerpt from what happened in Washington the day of the dick drawing. The jet pilot that drew a dick. Which, dude, that took skill, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
You made, like, circles for the balls and the shaft, you know? Here, let's play it right now. Ready? Here we go.
Colonel, you better take a look at this radar. What is it, son? I don't know, sir, but it looks like a giant dick.
Yeah.
Take a look out of starboard. Oh, my God, it looks like a huge...
pecker!
Oh, yeah.
Wait, that's not a woodpecker. It looks like someone's...
pirates! We have reports of an unidentified flying object. It is a long, smooth shaft, complete with two balls.
What is that? That looks just like an enormous
wang. Pay attention.
I was distracted by that enormous flying...
Willie.
Yeah.
What's that?
It's Willie Nelson.
Well, it looks like a giant...
Johnson.
who had the time to put that together?
Whoever
that's a lot of remembering of things that happened about dicks and willies and wangs in movies.
I think that was from a movie. I think that was already made. I could be wrong.
Oh, that's awesome, though.
I may be Wong.
I
knew a girl, a woman, a boss, actually. Her name was May
good.
Wong. Yeah.
Yeah?
I knew a woman once. Her name was May Wong, dude, and I used to make fun of her by saying, like, I
may be Wong.
I could be right, but I may be Wong. She had a file called the To Be Filed File, for real. And she, it was a retail store. It was a To Be Filed File, dude. It was thick. It was thick.
Someone wasn't filing.
No. It was our job to file, you know?
Well,
I'm not a file. I went to school for electronics.
That's why you drive for Uber.
Hey, that's a kind of company, man. Face of the company. You should see my Uber comments, man.
Yeah?
Oh, dude.
What's your rating on Uber?
Well, let's take a look, shall we? Why not? Here we go. It's now time. I gotta have a button for this, dude. Here we go.
I love how you hit it and then you look at me to make sure, like, is this funny? Are you gonna laugh now?
No, I was just looking at you like, I can't see with these glasses on, dude. That's why I put them on. All right, let's look at my ratings on Uber right now. I've got 151 five-star trips. My rating is 4.85. I have a 100% acceptance rate, a 0% cancellation rate, 37 rider compliments, and 9 notes where people say things like this. Thank you so much for your excellent service and great conversation. November 2017. Lovely. November 2017. Best Uber driver yet. October 2017.
Is that from the girl that you touched? I mean...
No, I groped. I didn't touch. I totally laid into her.
All right, Jameis.
I'm never going to forget seeing Batman in Tampa. We're going to eat a W. Welcome aboard. Where are you headed? We're going to eat a W. You want to eat a W? I mean, what is a W, dude? Is that like a Wang? No. We're going to eat a Wang today. Get with me. Oh, Jesus, dude. Amazing driver. Everything went well. Kevin was super, super, absolutely super. I mean, super terrific. He was extremely polite, friendly, and read more. Let's read more, shall we? And courteous, and I wish I could call him for all my Uber rides. He kindly assisted me with my walker and went the extra mile. Kevin is a tremendous asset to the Uber organization. Job well done!
Oh, Lord have mercy.
Good Lord, that is great.
It's time for Sweaty Palms Porn Review with Master Jason.
That is obviously the wrong button.
So, Jason, where are you at?
He's on the wall of fame right there.
Oh, there he is.
Yeah, Masturbation Jason.
Masturbation.
Yeah, he was our... resident porn review guy.
Oh,
you know?
That's awesome.
Yeah, he would watch porn movies and then give us feedback on what he watched. And he quit the show when we asked him to watch... do you remember... what was his name? Peter North? The porn star Peter North?
No.
He was famous for having large cum shots, like lots of semen.
Well done, Peter North.
Yeah. Well, apparently he went into gay porn and then came back to straight porn. So we asked Masturbation Station.
Masturbation Station. Three times fast.
It's your Masturbation Station. We asked him to do a porn review of one of the gay porns that Peter North did, and he was like, yeah, cool, no problem, I'll do it. And then he never called back. So,
oh,
I don't know. Yeah, we'll see what happens with Masturbation Jason. Actually, Sweaty Palms was a really good thing, dude. Check it out.
Slap your salami. It's time for the Sweaty Palms Porn Review with Master Jism Jason.
Jism Jason. Come on, man. Jism Jason's great. Anyway, I got a lot of flack, dude, on the fun page because, like, people called in, you know, when we first started the show, and then they were like, Kevin never invited us to call back in the show again. Dude, y'all can call anytime you want. 727-237-6010. Brian Walter out there, I know I owe you a swag pack. Michael Marilovich, I know I owe you for the red alpha male swordtail guppies that you sent Pops. I know, I
just
got
so everyone knows, he owes me a swag pack too, and I'm here, and I probably won't leave with
bro,
it.
Bro, here, I got swag packs.
Oh, here
you
go.
Yeah. I got business cards.
Now he just handed me a coupon for a free hug.
Yeah, that's a mouth hug.
Oh, all right.
I mean, it's... Where's
Laureate?
Oh! Whoa!
So I don't know if I'm going to be in trouble or you're going to be in trouble.
Yeah. Glick says that was Austin Powers from the whole look at the sky. What's that? You know that whole thing. Austin Powers. I don't know. Whatever. Just trying to change the subject so I don't get beat to death when I get home. Thanks, Dick.
No worries.
Whatever. I mean, Glick.
Hey, listen, Glick. You are what you eat. It's okay.
Oh man.
Oh, Glazed Rooster's in the house.
Oh whoa! Hold the phone.
Says your reverb is way the fuck up.
Sounds like somebody's jiggling your balls while you talk. Well, hey,
well, I am. So,
why is that?
Glad
dude?
We got the sound down.
All right, let me see if I just turn the trebles all the way down. Maybe is that better? Maybe that's better.
That's really bad.
It's echoing again, man. Damn it, dude.
Should we take a break, maybe?
It's this board, man. Son of a bitch, dude. Something's broken. On the Kevin Holly Show mixer. Wow. That really sucks. Wow. I'm listening to you play that back for me.
That sounds terrible.
It really does. I mean, it's, like, almost not worth doing a show. I don't get it, dude. I don't know what happened. I mean, it makes no sense. It really doesn't. I mean, everything's set perfectly.
Clay said you're still jiggling.
Yeah, I am. I'm still jiggling. Aaron, man. Does the sound effects do it, too? Let's try it. Ready to go? Here we go.
He needs some milk!
Wait for it. Wait for it. Waiting. Wait for it. That wasn't as bad, huh?
No, that wasn't nearly as bad.
So it's the microphones. All right, let me try turning off my microphone.
Hey, guys, what's going on? Welcome to the Aaron Martin Show. Kevin Holly is out of the house.
It's on there, too, man. Hold on a sec. Wow. Hey, check that out. That is some serious reverb. Turn that off. Yeah. None of that's supposed to do any of that, dude. Oh, I think I figured it out. How about now? Okay, that wasn't it. We're back.
You're not saying how about now, though?
Yeah, because I turned this all off. That makes no sense, man. Like, that's... Okay. Hold on a second. No. I can't figure it out, dude. How about... Wait a minute.
Dead air. Man, we're working on it, Glick.
Yeah, we're totally working on it. How about now? Now it's blinking, though. That doesn't make any sense. None of this should be blinking. Why is it blinking? Alright, these should all be off. I don't know, man. I don't know what the hell happened to this board.
Sounds like it's just getting worse.
How about now? Son of a bitch, dude. This is a disaster. Dead air. Yeah, I know. I'm working on it, man. I'm working on it. I'm trying to fix this crap. Mm-hmm. That's okay. You know why it's okay? Because we're not on the IRN. And if I want to, I could just delete this whole... Hire an audio tech. It's not my fault, dude. It's Hoppy's fault. It happened during Hoppy Hour.
It did.
It totally did. I know he didn't do anything. I'm not calling him out. But I just don't understand why my board is blinking now. Here, I have an idea.
I'm going to unplug it and plug it back in. Dead air time.
I just realized that this was sitting here.
Alright. Imagine the robot from Lost in Space getting banged by C-3PO while Predator is filming it. That is what y'all sound like. Thanks, Glazed Rooster. Haas in the house. What's up, Rob Haas? Big Rob. Trucker Rob, everybody. Trucker Rob in the house. Trucker Rob was giving me crap the other day, saying that, oh, I was on chat room for like 30 minutes and nobody even recognized me or said anything. And I'm like, I'm all about like, oh, really? I'm like, how about this, Trucker Rob?
Trucker Rob on the Kevin Holly Show. When he's not driving trucks, he's knucking futs.
How about a little of this?
Trucker Rob. Trucker Rob. Trucker Rob. Trucker Rob. Trucker Rob. Trucker Rob. Drive a truck. Trucker Rob. Driving trucks is all he wants to do. Drive a truck. Trucker Rob. Driving trucks because he loves you.
Trucker Rob on the Kevin Holly Show. When he's not driving trucks, he's knucking futs.
Wait. So anyways, make sure y'all check out the Glick Show every Saturday 10. I don't know why the fucking thing is blinking, man. It's killing me. Look at it. It's like, it's on reverb. It's not on. I noticed. I can't.
It sounds fine to us, though. That's what I don't get.
Yeah, but it's blinking, which I don't get. I don't have a clue, dude. I don't know what the hell's going on here. I really don't. Nothing's different, dude. I mean,
this sounded fine.
Yeah, yeah. It's like our microphones are bad or something. But they're not, dude. Everything's fine in here. Just here, let me try turning it up way loud. Check, 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 check. Cock chat. Cock chat. No. Alright, we're just gonna do a studio test here. Maybe the mics are fried. Thanks, Rob. I appreciate your input on that one. Maybe the mics are fried. Is it better?
That, hold on. Yeah, that sounds a lot better. Can you drop your...
Yeah. No, I mean...
No, I'm saying if you drop your headphones and listen, it sounds a lot better.
I can hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I can totally hear it.
Now it just went bad again.
Really?
No.
I think it's okay now.
Hey, guys, that sound good out there?
Yeah, a little echo through here. Let's turn it on.
Check, check. Hello, hello. Check, check, check.
That's it, man.
Hold on. Check, check, check. Check one. Check. Check, 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 check. No more echo.
No.
No more echo.
We're good. Look
we're
at good. That.
We're back. Holy shit, we're back. Are we good? You know what it is? It's the cable coming out of the mixer going into the monitor.
So what if you just undo that one?
Then we wouldn't have a monitor. That's cool. That's a great idea. That's why I keep you around, brother. Let's do it. Ready?
I just got hired as the audio tech, everybody.
Alright. What the fuck? Alright. So now, it's still blinking. It's still blinking. It's still blinking! But I think we're better now. I'm so glad we're not live on the IRN right now. Holy shit. What do you think, dude? Wait for it.
That's fine.
We're good. That's what it was. It's a goddamn monitor. I'll just turn the monitor off, too.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Kevin Holly Show.
Welcome back. Time for a 37-minute break. Thank you, Glaze Rooster. All right. Oh, we may as well do a quick IRN promo. Why not? Here we go. Let's see if this works.
This is Kevin Holly, host of The Kevin Holly Show, live on the IRN Internet Radio Network. One time I fell down the stairs. I know somebody who actually put a cat in their freezer. I have two guinea pigs. I have a goldfish that's 5 years old. I have a huge suckerfish. It's a Pleco clitoris. You are listening to the IRN Internet Radio Network. The Kevin Holly Show, live on the IRN Internet Radio Network.
All right, we're back, Aaron.
Good job, Rob. I almost laughed at that.
It's still fucking blinking though, dude. Look at it.
Hey, listen, but it sounds fine.
Okay.
I think. Does this still sound okay, guys?
I hope so. Oh my god. Motherfucker. All right. So that happened. That was a lot of fun. Wow. So simple. Stupid broken cable. I think it's good, man.
Well, you got duct tape wrapped around the cables, you should know that they could be broken.
Let me call it on my shit, bro. I almost called you Ryan. I'm sorry.
You said Ryan?
Yeah, I almost called you Ryan.
I've been called Ryan before. Do I look like a Ryan?
Now Haas says audio sucks again. Robbie spelled dog wrong. I'm listening. Rob's fucking with us. I think it just means the show sucks.
Thanks, Rob. Appreciate it.
Appreciate it? Do you appreciate it?
Yeah, you appreciate it.
You appreciate it. Man, that really sucks, Aaron.
Do you want to play the pyramid game? We can just get right back into something.
After the break? Yeah, let's break now, and then we'll be back in time for the IRN feed. And then everything will be hunky-dory.
We'll see you guys in a little bit.
Well, hold on a second.
Oh, okay.
I gotta find out where my break shit is, dude. Because everything's fucked. Oh, you know what? That's going to take a sec. Oh, this place is just so fucked, man. It is so fucked. It really is, dude. So, hey, Aaron, how was your drive up to the studio today? How's Pops doing?
No, dude, I'll tell you, man. So, I brought pizza with me, and this pizza place, it'll be a 15-minute wait. I got there at 7 o'clock. I didn't have pizza in hand until 7:33. She kept going, just one more minute, just one more minute. I go, are you adding these minutes together to make 33 minutes? Or what are we doing here? They were waiting on breadsticks.
Why? I mean, is breadsticks even worth waiting for? You should have just, give me the pie!
I should have, but anyways, I was here on time. I told her, I said, I just got to get to the studio. They're like, oh, what do you do?
Oh, God. Like, Did you name drop me? Did you name drop me at Pizza Hut?
I totally said, I was like, yep. I said, a friend runs a radio show. You know, you guys should listen. It's the Kevin Holly Show.
Oh, God.
And she's like, oh, that's so cool. You know?
That's so cool. And then she was like, yeah. She walked away. Oh, man, it's not so cool tonight. I hope that the Pizza Hut crew isn't listening.
Well, oh, and then some guy came in. I guess he ordered online at his house, and he ordered to the wrong Pizza Hut. And she's like, we don't have your order. And he's like, you should have my order. And he starts yelling at her, and I felt bad. So I was like, man, I said, do you just want to reorder your pizza? He goes, I'll just order it here. So he ordered it online, and he got, like, a special online deal that they can't honor in the store.
Oh.
So I handed him my phone. I was like, here, just use my app. I said, it's okay. He goes, no, I don't need you paying for my shit. I'm like, no, I'm not paying for it. You're ordering it. Then you'll pay the pretty young lady here. And
did you grope her?
And he got all offended, you know. And he's like, no, I'll just figure it out. Then he couldn't figure it out. Couldn't download the app right. So then he's like, okay, I'll do it. And I'm like, you should have just done it in the first fucking place, like I said.
Well, that's something good to do while you're waiting for your breadsticks anyway. You did a good deed.
I did a good deed.
Hey, do you think if Mr. Roper groped Janet or Chrissy on Three's Company that they would call him Mr. Groper?
I don't know, to be honest with you.
I think that would be an appropriate name for him.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's where our shows come to.
All right.
Now, yeah.
Cock chat.
It's not... Cock chat! We will be going to break here in a moment, momentarily. Let's go to the chat room real quick. I just stopped in to say hello. Paint and blah, 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 blah. Take it easy, says Glazed Rooster. Looks like he might have a case of the Kevin Holly Show sucks syndrome tonight. No, we love Glazed Rooster, man. Hopefully soon he'll sit in with us. That one day that he asked a couple of weeks ago when we had Sunshine and Bullets and Luke McDermott in here, he had called me earlier that day and was like, hey, man, I'm going to be around. And he was like in Tampa or something. He wasn't too far away than from where he normally lives. And I was like, dude, I don't know if it's just going to be me alone tonight or what's going on. I said, so I don't want to have you, because he wanted to bring like donuts and stuff. And I was like, you're welcome to come here anytime. Glazed Rooster, you're totally welcome to come here anytime. But I didn't want him to like go out of his way and get a bunch of food if it was just going to be me and him. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
or me, him, and Luke. And it turned out to be, like, me, Luke, you know, Sunshine Bullets, Filbert showed up later, and then they all got mad that I didn't have Glazed Rooster show up with all these stats. He's totally fucking cool, though, man. I love that guy. So, that being said, let's go take our first break, come back, try and get on the IRN, and get the show going, Aaron.
Let's do it.
For fuck's sake. All right, we'll be right back after this short 39-minute break. No, it'll be like, I don't know, 10, 12 minutes, something like that. We'll be right back.
That nigga's got me hot. If you know this shit, sing along. Nigga's got me hot. Hey, well, that's exactly where the nigga came from. You, taking shots from afar, I'ma meet you at your front door. So hard to be doing what you really meant for, beauty. But don't I make it look easy, don't I make it look easy. You drank up all my liquor, come on, what I'm supposed to do now. And you talking all that shit, now come on, you gon' have to back it up. If I get too high now, sugar, come on, I might never come down. Let me get the full scope. Full screen HD, let me pull it to the picture. Let me holla at the pre-show. Cool beans, that's a whole lot of reefer. Let me help you with the pre-roll. You drank up all my liquor, come on. What I'm supposed to do now? And
I am your host, Ryan Hoppin.
I'm your co-host, Steve Miller.
And I'm your echo chamber. Holly.
All right. Before we wrap up the show.
This echo, is this classy news? Is the echo on for classy news?
What did you do? Let me out of here.
Look, I don't know a lot about radio, and I'm the radio engineer, but you did something.
Did you step on something?
You said I did nothing, and that's a lie.
Steve, this is where Hoppy kills us.
Yeah, this is the sound of the bottom of the well.
Let us go.
What is this?
I'm the ghost of Radio Past. Hoppy, stop trying.
What if there's no echo for the listeners and it's just in our headphones?
That would be very depressing. We would all sound like we're on a buttload of mescaline right now. Doesn't this sound weird? No, it sounds fine.
Do you put mescaline in your butt?
Yes. Quicker absorption rate.
Yeah, like a suppository, right?
Yeah. Mescaline in my butt and popsicle in my mouth. Don't mess them up. Very sticky.
Could you imagine for the radio show like this? We're just echoing for 4 hours.
You are. Right now.
Yeah. You don't need to imagine it. We're living it. I like that you're making no effort to correct the echo. We're just full.
Don't do that.
We're just full.